when you kind of are not in that flow anymore, you almost forget how to behave on camera. I like the bro soap. Yeah, never mind. Let me get some coffee. Do I also have clean fingers? No. Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to my channel. If you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands. Hence the accent and the move is done. This is the very first video, true video, that I'm going to film here. The moving vlog thing, video, whatever, should be up already. I will link it underneath the cards. And yeah, if you have seen that, you kind of know how this will turn out. I don't know yet. Because yeah, for obvious reasons, I'm not there yet. So yeah, I also have not filmed in, I think it's about a week. So yeah, and the weird thing is, you would think that because I have been doing this for a few years, I would kind of know how everything works. But it's just, when you kind of are not in that flow anymore, you almost forget how to behave on camera. So never mind. I have a lot of newness to play with. And I have grabbed some things out of my basket. I am going to play with, well, a lot of new things. I'm going to play with DJ's Unique Boutique. I have it here. This is my palette, but I have single shades here. So here they are. And I'm hoping that it kinda looks like it is true to color, which is very nice, because I don't know white balance. I kinda need to see how everything works. So I also swatched the shades. They are here. I hope you can see. They feel a little bit drier, the shimmers, but yeah, that's not a bad thing, I think. I also have hairs here, because this is the only place that is free for me to swatch, because, you know. So I want to play with those. She also sent me 3 of the 4 lip glosses. There's also a blue one, but yeah, I know I won't use it. So basically they correspond with the shade. So this is the rosy gold, which corresponds with the rose gold shade. Can you even see? I hope so. And then this one is Purple Unicorn, which corresponds with this shade. And then I have here, this one is called Brown Sugar. I have tried this one. I do like the formula. So I want to play with those today as well. I have an itchy nose. I also have from the brand Pout & Snout a blush and bronzer. The only trouble is though that they kinda, I wasn't careful enough with them, so I had to press them back in, but that's okay. So I will show you the components in a minute. Here are the shades. This is the bronzer and this is the blush. It looks like they oxidize a little bit on me, which isn't a bad thing. I did kind of build up the blush a little bit because it's pretty light. I don't know if I can use this as a bronzer or maybe even more as a blush shade. It does not really matter, because yeah, I bought them because I love her brand, I love her aesthetics, and the components are just everything. So I'm very, very careful. Let me put the carton in so that I can show you the component without hopefully falling. So here is the component of the bronzer. How cool is this, guys? I just needed this, you know? You can order through DM on Instagram, and I will leave her DM, her Instagram handle down below. But it's just, the shades are very delicate. They arrived very well packaged. They were still in one piece, but I am just not careful enough, apparently, today. So yeah, so that's the bronzer. And I'm going to not close the component of the blush all the way, because it is, for me at least, kind of hard to open sometimes. So here is the blush component. Can you see? How cool is this? And it is Lazy Susan. That's what it says in the yellow. It's just, yeah, what's not to like, you know? So I have that. I also have a new foundation. I did not buy this though. I got this sent by Steph. Her channel name is Not Your Basic Steph. She lives in the UK and we kind of swapped foundations. So she sent me the WOMA foundation in the shade Honey T1 Neutral, which is basically their lightest olive shade. I swatched it it's a bit too dark. So what I think I'm going to do, I'm just going to grab my Fenty concealer because this is very, very light. And maybe I can kind of mix because I've heard so many good things about the foundation that I really want to try it. I also have a new primer. This one got sent to me from one of you. And I don't know if you want me to say your name, so I'm not going to. But this is from Kiko. This is the Smart Urban Shield Face Primer 2-in-1 Pollution Plus Blue Light Protector. So that's what I'm going to use today. I also have some newness from Catrice. I also have two new palettes from Catrice, but I won't use them in the video today because I want to do separate videos on them. So I will show you. If you follow me on Instagram, you have seen these already. These are two new Pro palettes. So here we have the Pro Peach Origin. Let me show it to you. So here's the color story. And then the other one is this one, the Lavender Breeze. This one reminds me of the Norvina from ABH. I don't have that one, so I cannot compare it. So yeah, separate videos on these will come. I will probably do two looks per palette, which I usually do with these Pro palettes. And if that formula is anything like their other Pro palettes, I know I'm really going to like it. But because I have some other things from Catrice that I don't necessarily want to do a different video about, you know, separate video, yeah. They also came out with a soap brow stylus. So this is the Brow Fix Soap Stylist. Full and fluffy, that's what it's called. And yeah, this is the component looks very, very nice. I have not used this one, so I will. I really like soap brow, and I used soap brow a lot until I got my Guilty Cosmetics brow jam in. But I really want to try this one. They also came out with a new... What is this? Eyeliner. This is the Glam & Doll Easy Wash Off Power Hold Eyeliner. And they say that this is kind of waterproof, but it washes away with warm water. So I was like, that is very, very interesting. I really want to try it. So basically, it's like a tube mascara. And it is a... Oh, it does feel nice. Is it a brush tip? No. It's not... This is the... It's very thin. It's not a brush tip, I think. It... Huh. It's a felt tip, but it is a flexible felt tip. So it doesn't seem to bleed. So here it is. Doesn't seem to bleed. I'm very, very interested in this. I am using their tattoo liner right now. I'm very, very curious. So I have that. Yes, what else do I have? Oh yeah, lippies. I think I almost have a full face of newness. Yeah, except for brow pencil and mascara. So yeah, I also have a new brush. This is from Douglas, and I got this sent by one of you as well, the same as the Kiko primer, because this is your favorite brush from Douglas, and I'm very, very interested to try that as well. I just need to think about what I'm going to pair this with though. Okay, I think I kind of have it figured out. For the mattes, I'm just going to use this one, the 5-in-a-box from Catrice, because it has a little bit more of a neutrals in it, because I want to let the shimmer shine. Pun not really intended, but kinda a little. Usually I do primer first, then soap. So let's do that now as well. So let's start with the primer from Kiko. Okay, so it has a little bit of a tint. Okay, does not really smell like anything, which I like. It feels nice. Does not feel really heavy on the skin. I can feel it turning a little bit sticky, which I kind of like as well. Okay, let's get the soap. Where's my... Usually, soap brow I use with a brush like this. So let's do that. I spray the brush. I spray once in the soap, just with some water. And then I kind of make a little bit of a... Do that, you know. I have found, though, personally, that I don't like it if the soap is too wet. I'm going to brush it down first to get a little bit of product in, and then I'm going to brush it up. You can also do it with a spoolie if you want to. There was not a spoolie included in this, but I don't know. I kind of like, again, using the soap brow with a brush. Oh yes, and my nails, in case you're wondering, they're actually from Primark. They're very, very cute. These are just press-on nails or glue-on nails. The only thing, though, is that these charms, can you see? Yeah, let's just say that I was glad that I had a top coat for some other stuff, because I already lost one here. So yeah, if you have something like this, make sure that you glue them down properly, or just make sure that you cannot stick to anything, you know. Okay, let's feel. Well, this is setting, that's good. Now I do have to say, with soap I like it when it is set but not completely set. So I'm going to put in my brow pencil now. Usually I do my foundation first, but yeah, I don't want the soap to harden up too much before I put in the pencil. I kind of like this. I like the feel of the soap in my brow. Oh, they're having a party. Yeah, I like it. I feel like it is setting against my face. I like it. So that is good. It is a little bit more of a stiffer soap than the Makeup Revolution one and the one that I had from AliExpress. But I don't mind that at all, to be honest. So far, I like the bro soap. Yeah, never mind. Let me get some coffee. Okay, let me get some eyeshadow primer. What's the primer I'm going to use? I think I'm going to use my Natasha Denona one, because it's a little bit warmer. So maybe I can kind of warm up the matte shadows a little bit more. And then I'm just going to very, very quickly and easily whack on my matte shadows. It's just very, very simple. I use this one as a transition shade and deepened it up with this one. That's what I did. Actually, the reason that I chose neutral shades is because I did not really know what I wanted to create. Basically, usually neutrals go with everything, right? So, oh yeah, what did I want to use? I know that I want to use the rose gold. And I think I wanted to use the green, right? Because I think that will be cutesy. So let's get brushes. I don't know if these need a shimmer base though. Let's try one eye with a shimmer base and the other eye without. I usually, lately I actually stopped using a shimmer primer. But let's do it on one eye. Let me get a brush. And I just put a little bit of primer on the brush. And just tap it on my eye. And the reason I stopped using a shimmer primer, because you see that fold there? What happens there? A lot of the time, especially lately, I don't know, it almost seems to rub away there. And yeah, it's just annoying. So I think I have it figured out. I'm going to use the shade Moon Dust in the outer corner. So let's start with that one then. It's actually dry and a tiny bit on primer. Very pretty. I kind of like it dry, but I kind of want to see what happens when I spray it as well. So I'm picking up shadow on the brush, and then I'm spraying my brush. I'm not going to go into the shadow with a wet brush. Oh, this is a very pretty color. The swatch does not do it justice at all. Okay, the other side I kind of want to not use a shimmer primer. Let's see what happens, the difference. I think these will benefit from a shimmer primer though. It's a very, very pretty shade, because when I swatch it, it is a multi-dimensional, but when I put it on my eye, it's very, very pretty. I don't know, it is almost gray bluish. I don't know what it is kind of color, but it is gorgeous. I think I'm going to go to, Purple Unicorn next. This looks almost a little bit more like a satiny. Dry first, but this is on top of the shimmer primer. Oh, that's a nice combination. I'm spraying. Yeah, so spraying works as well, but I do think that they show up very, very well on top of a shimmer primer. So it's basically whatever you want to do. I am going to go between the colors now to make sure that the mix is nice. And how do I do that? One side is one shade, the other side is the other shade. I'm just going to flip my brush back and forth. Yeah, the next shade is going to be the rosy gold, which is just the rose gold. And then I'm just going to go to the second shade, the one that I have there. It's the mixing them is very, very nice. So I want that a little bit more on top of that pinky shade. Very pretty. Very pretty. Now I kind of want a different matte shadow. So let me grab my chinchilla palette, because there is a... I think I want this shadow, yes. Where is the... Oh yes, I wanted to use this brush. So I'm also going to use a brush. I'm going to go into the this shade in the chinchilla palette. I switched to a fluffier brush because I need to blend it a bit. And I know I already have browns down, but that's okay. Okay, then I'm going to go to this one. Shall I do the blue underneath my eye? Sure, why not? I'm going to grab some glitter primer on the back of my hand. And then with this brush, the one from Douglas, I'm going to put that underneath my eye. Just stamping. And then I'm going to grab the blue shade, which is called Caribbean Waters. And I'm putting a tiny bit in the outer corner as well. And then I'm cleaning the brush a bit and I'm going to go back into that darker shimmer that I have here as well in the outer corner. Let's also grab a pop of green, but I need a different brush for that. I need a very tiny brush for that. I'm going to go to the shade called Enchanted Forest, because this one has a little bit of blue in it. Yes, this is it so far. I need to clean up the face. And how do I usually... This is going to be a long-ass video. I usually use my eye primer for that. So, my face primer. So, basically, I put down primer. And then I take a cloth. Sometimes I even put primer on the cloth, because it does not really matter. And then I'm going to clean up a bit. I made such a big mess, but it's all okay. It will all come together in the ending, I think. I think it's time for foundation almost. Let me do a little bit of color correcting first with my Makeup Revolution peach. Okay, then foundation. Let's shake and have some coffee. Okay, I don't even know. Is this a hydrating foundation? I don't even know what kind of foundation it is. The Say What Weightless Soft Matte Hydrating Foundation. Okay. Ah, I have an itchy nose. Okay. Let's do two pumps. Where's my concealer? Here. Because it's way too dark. And they don't have a lighter olive, because I've already checked. Yeah, it's still too dark, but we will just run with it. I forgot to wet the sponge, so let me do that, and then I will be right back. It is too dark still, but I will kind of lighten it up with some concealer, I think. It is pretty though. Maybe this will be very nice in summer, color-wise, you know? And I tan pretty quickly, so... Yeah, and let's also bring it down the neck a little. I don't really know when this video is going online, because I haven't planned it yet. But it could very well... Very well be that when by the time you are watching this, I have... new tattoos, because yes, I'm getting new tattoos finally. I feel like I have a very little amount on my face, which is good. This is very, very pale though, compared to... I think I will get my Revolution 5.7, which is probably too light as well, but this is a little bit darker than the Fenty. Let's lighten it up a tad. Hmm. Is it very, very... I don't know, it does look very pretty, guys. I'm not gonna lie. Maybe I can... this dries down... Oh, wow. Maybe I can mix this with the Urban Decay Stay Naked. I can see why people are raving about this foundation. Just because of the way that it feels. And the way that it looks on the skin. You know, I if you are new, I love drugstore. I love my drugstore foundations. The one from Catrice, the HD foundation, has been my go-to for years. I do know, though, that now that I am trying some higher-end foundations, and not all. For instance, the Estee Lauder Double Wear, I did not. Yeah, it was nice, but I don't think it was worth $50. This one is also more expensive, but it does look very, very pretty. Yeah, it is too dark for me, so I need to lighten it up. However, maybe I can lighten it up with either the Stay Naked foundation from Urban Decay, or maybe even the Fenty, because this dries down on its own as well. I used a very, very small amount. Yeah, it is too dark for me, but oh lord, I do really... Yeah, you know, I can understand why people rave about this foundation. So Steph, thank you so much for sending me this one. And the only thing though is I don't really know what kind of pencil I want. Maybe both. Maybe kind of halfway a little bit. And this is the LA Girl Shockwave Neon Liner in Gotcha. I could also have done an orange. I could have done a pink. But let's do this one. Just in the outer corner. Yeah, I like that. Okay, inner corner. I want that shade... called Pink Chameleon. Shall I be fancy and put it underneath the brow bone too? I usually don't do that. But let's be fancy. I just whacked on a little bit of contour. Cream contour. That's actually the only thing I'm going to do. Because I want to see how the rest is. First though, I almost forgot. I need freckles. But... let me get a new... yes, let me get a new Lottie London one because my other one was empty. So let's put on some freckles. Let's go to the bronzer. I am going to grab a fluffy brush. Stipple it on a little bit first. Truly, I don't know if this is the correct shade for me. And it does not really matter because that's not... I wanted to try her formula. But I also just really love her brand, you know. And I just wanted to support her. So that is why I bought this. And I think I can use this shade as a blush too. And I'm being very, 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 very delicate with it because, yeah, I wasn't before, you know. I don't know how it will look outside though, but on camera it actually looks a little bit warm, but that is not bad for bronzer, you know. So let me put this thing back and kind of press a bit. Okay, like that, yes. The blush. I'm going to use the same brush. I'm just cleaning it off on the towel that I have here. I quite like this color. I think she described this as a peachy one. I never know what a peach is because I also always think that the peach is more orangey than it is because a lot of the time it's more pink than I think it is. I do know though that if you are have an olive undertone, a peach is very, very pretty. I was afraid that this would be too light for me, but it's actually not. And the foundation that I have on is basically this is more along the lines of my summer color, not height of summer, but yeah, kind of summer color. So maybe then you will know. But yeah, I think I really, really like this one. So that is very good. I just need to make sure that I don't close the component all the way, because I have a very, very hard time opening the component. Okay, so let me show you the purple unicorn gloss first. Oh, that is nice. That's actually very, very pretty with this eye look. I like this. Okay, let me put on the next one, which is then the rosy gold. Oh no, let me put on brown sugar first, because I want to wear rosy gold. I'm not going to bother with a lip liner right now. It's very pretty. They are also very, very comfortable. And this is just basically your normal wearable dark brown gloss. Now the one that I'm very excited for. So let me, where is my, why? Thank you. Shall I do a darker lip liner instead of this one? Maybe that's better. Let's fill it in because I can. So this is a lip liner from Elf, from their Retro Paradise set. I don't know I don't know. But I like it. So I'm going to put on the rosy gold next. I like this. I think this is very pretty and it's very unique. Now, when I kind of looked at them, I like them both. I like them all. I like the formula a lot. I like them all three. I like the colors. I have swatched the colors here. What I really like about this one, though, is that it is just... It reminds me of the Becca highlighter that I have. That basically the greeniness that fades into my skin tone a little bit more. And this reminds me of it. And I think it is very, very pretty. I love all the glosses. Glosses. I think the formula is very nice. Nice, thin formula. Not very sticky, not very gloopy. I also like a very sticky gloss though. But yeah, that's me. I like it. A lot. I'm not done though. No, it's going to be such a nightmare. I need to do the eyeliner and mascara and falsies. I don't think I can do the eyeliner on camera though. Everything is on. Here is the completed look. Long live the scarf. It will help hide the fact that my face is a lot darker than my neck. But yeah, let me go over everything that I used. Before I forget, the falsies I have on are from AOA Studio in the style Amanda, cut really short. So basically they start here and then that happened. Yeah, and that's, yeah, mascaras from Essence. It will be listed down below. Let me go over everything that I used. Let's start with the brow soap. No, let's start with the primer because that was the first thing, right? Primer feels nice. Yeah, that's basically all I can say about it. It feels nice. I do want to test it out. I'm really curious to see how it will perform underneath the Fenty foundation, because I found that that foundation, I need a hydrating primer underneath to be able to work with it a little bit longer than 2 seconds. So yeah, but so far I like it. I don't know if it will keep my makeup on any longer, but I do like it. So I'm going to keep on using it and will let you know in a future video how I feel about it. The brow soap. I'm going basically in order of application. The brow soap. I really like this brow soap. I think out of the brow soaps that I have tried, I like this one the best. And I have tried 3 in total. I've tried the one from Revolution. I've tried one from AliExpress. And I actually think that I like this one the best. Just because of the fact that it keeps my brows in place without being a very thick, heavy layer. Yeah, I have very rambunctious brows, so I want them plastered to my head. It wasn't too wet. I like it. I will keep on using it. I don't know if I like it better than my brow jam, because it is similar, but it is different. So I will keep on trying this one out as well. First impression, I really, really like it. Then we're going to go to the eyeshadows from DJ's Unique Boutique. When I felt them, they felt a little bit dry, which I don't really mind. These two are a little bit more I want to say creamy, and then the rest are a little bit more flaky. I think that is the best way to describe them. I think they're very, very pretty. I do think that you need that. Yeah, on top of a glitter primer, they perform very, very well. And otherwise, spray your brush. But I think these just benefit from a glitter primer. I am going to test them though. Because yeah, usually I don't really wear a glitter primer. So I'm actually very curious to see how they will behave on both eyes. Because this eye does have a glitter primer underneath and this one doesn't. Underneath my eye though, if I put a shimmer there, I usually put a glitter primer there anyway to get them to stick. Yeah, that's it. I almost used all of them. I did not use this one. And I did not use two middle ones. Those are the only two that I didn't use. The rest I used. Yeah, I really like them. This shade Moon. I think it was Moondust, right? Yeah, Moondust. That blew me away. I knew that I would like this one. But this one really blew me away. But because when I look at it, it's pretty. It's a purple with a kind of a greeny, almost a grayish to it, and then when I put it on my eye, oh, it's so pretty, so pretty. So yeah, again, I think that they benefit from a glitter primer, or that you need to spray your brush, and they are a little bit of a drier formula, so if you don't like that, then maybe these are not for you. There are not many shimmer formulas that I truly do not like though. So I think they are very, very pretty. Foundation. Yeah, I think it's very pretty. I do really like the way that it feels. I haven't set it and I did not really need to. Let me zoom you in a little bit. Maybe that is a bit better. Hello. So yeah, it does look very, very pretty. It does not settle into lines. It just looks too dark. I can kind of, let me do this. Oh, that's very, very dark. Can I then do that? That's a little better. So you can at least see a little bit better. I did not really build it up a lot. So you can still see my skin through. But I do think it looks pretty. Let me put everything back the way I wanted it. So yeah. Okay, let's zoom out again. Something like that. So yeah, that was the foundation. So far, I really, really like it. I don't know how it will wear. I don't know. It feels like skin. And that is what I noticed with the Urban Decay Stay Naked foundation. And my Fenty one as well, actually. And I think this will be a foundation that I will enjoy in summer as well. Because it just feels so weightless, you know. So yeah, I really like it. And I will keep on testing it out. The only thing though, yeah, it's too dark. So I need to mix it with something lighter. The bronzer and the blush. Yeah, I like these. I like these a lot. This one, it looks very pretty on my skin, at least on camera. Again, I don't really know what it looks like outside. It is a little bit, I don't want to say a very, very luminous, but maybe a little bit more shimmery than a satin. I really like it. I like the formula. I just love this. You know, it says factor 50 keeps me nifty, 10-year height. Yeah, you know, it's just the whole experience. I do have to be very careful with it because it is a very soft formula though. But I really like it. The blush, yeah, I love this. The only thing that I want to bitch about is that I have a very hard time opening the component. Or maybe I can... I think I can kind of see. Do you see here? Can you see that it is a little bit black? That's where the paint is rubbing off. So maybe if I file it just very lightly or sand it down, it will go a little bit easier. Because I do want to keep using these. Because when I saw this, I was like, I think it's too light for me. But the foundation is two shades or maybe even three shades too dark. Anyway, so yeah. So that means that I can use this in summer as well. And I really do like the color. I think it's very pretty. I like the formula as well. It's a softer formula. I just have to be careful with it. So actually what she did is she put cardboard here. I'm just going to keep the cardboard in and then basically press what I used. I'm just going to press back down because it's a very loose formula. And the brush that I use makes it even looser. But yeah, I really like this. You know, it's just the whole thing. I really like it. So even if it's kind of with that brow gem. Even if I thought that the formulation wasn't good. Yeah, I still would have loved it. But I think the formula is very, very nice. So yeah. Then the last thing that was new that I used is the eyeliner. I have to get used to dipping in because I use a brush tip. So usually I don't have to dip in. I'm very curious to see if this will stay. And yeah, that's it. If it will stay and if it will be very easy then to remove with warm water. I'm actually very curious about that. So I will keep on trying that. What I did notice though, and I think you can still see it. Let me zoom you in again. Can you see that here it hasn't bled, which is usually where it bleeds for me, in the inner part, and then especially this eye, because apparently, I don't know, that eye has more lines in it. I don't know. But yeah, I can build it up nicely. I do feel like the formula is a little bit stiffer almost when, oh, that's a little bit too far. When it dries down, it almost feels a little bit stiffer than the brush tip. But I'm very, very curious to see how this will hold up. Very curious. This is also from their new line. I bought the stuff from Catrice at Boozy Shop, but I've also seen it on Cosmetic for Less. Do they have everything? I don't know. Cosmetic for Less does ship internationally, but not to the USA. And Catrice from Boozy Shop is not sold outside of the Netherlands, because I think that is then Cosmetic for Less. So if you live here, you can check Boozy Shop. That's where I bought mine, and I will link Boozy Shop. And then the rest, for the rest, I will also link Cosmetic for Less. Oh yeah, the glosses. I almost forgot the glosses. I so like these. She asked me if I wanted them all or if there was a shade that I wouldn't use, and I opted out of the very dark blue one, which is then the ocean. Yeah, because I was like, I don't think that I will use this one. And I was like, when I got them in, I was like, I will use this one for sure because it's just a brown. You know, it's a nude. It can go with everything. But I'm actually, yeah, these two kind of surprised me. That I would like this color. When I saw it, I kind of knew that I would like this color because I love a color like this. But this surprised me as well. They are sheer enough that they that I don't have blue purple lips. Because I don't mind a wonky lip color, but it's not always what I go for. But they are opaque enough to give that hint of something. So when I put this one on, it is more, yeah, it really complements the eye look. So, and I really, really like the formula as well. Now, this is a formula that is, it's light. It has more substance than a lip oil because it stays on top of your lips more. So it is a light formula. It's not too gloopy. It's not very sticky. It is a formula that I like, but not always. And I kind of need to explain that because I also really like a sticky formula. If it is, I don't know, windy and I'm going outside, I like a sticky gloss. Because I feel like that I don't have to apply that one as much. This one though, yeah, even if I color outside of the lines, especially with this one, I don't think it will matter that much. I actually, to be honest with you, think this is my favorite. And I did not think it would be my favorite. So yeah. So thank you so, so much again, DJ, for sending me this. And if you don't know, DJ also has her own YouTube channel. It's just PGD, and it will be linked down below as well. I will also link her site down below so you can check her out. I will link Pout and Shout, Pout and Snout, Pout and Snout, Instagram's handle down below. And then the rest was Catrice, right? I think so. Yeah, my makeup will be listed down in the description box. I had a lot of fun filming. Oh yeah, and I will link Steph's channel. Because yeah, she's the one who sent me the Woma Beauty Foundation. We can get it here on Beauty Bay, so I will link it on Beauty Bay as well. This was it. I had a lot of fun filming again. It was almost like, on the one hand, that I never left. And on the other hand, I'm like, I don't really know what to do anymore. But that's okay. I really like the look. And I feel pretty. So yeah, and I will keep on trying the goodies and let you know my thoughts. Let me know down below if you have any of this. And yeah, That's going to be it. I'm going to go to the site to give a special thank you to my members that you will see scrolling on the screen right now. If you want to become a member, there is a link to join in the description box. There's also a link to the Teespring merch shop in case you want to browse there. And then that is going to be it for today. If you have made it this far, leave me... there is not a nest. Leave me the dodo. If you have the dodo, because... Yeah, there's not a raven emoji. I'm into the dodo. So leave me the dodo emoji if you can find it. Yes. And otherwise a kitty cat. That's good as well. Thank you, guys. I'm going to... Wow. This was it. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. Or at least, if it doesn't, just put on a scarf like I did today. And I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye, guys. Thank you.